Mini chapter 29, Ashley at home in the Century Park East apartment. Ashley's home is within easy walking distance of the Avenue of the Stars Tower, in discreetly low-rise luxury at the top of a bank of greenery on Century Park East between Galaxy Way and Empyrean Way. Not that anyone normal would actually walk that commute, of course, they would drive. Though tight wound, Ashley is in some respects abnormal, however, and this is one such respect, so she walks it. Amber therefore sets off tailing her on foot, at what he and his creator judge to be a prudent distance, down through the anodyne crispness of Century City, while Jaymi peers in voyeuristic excitement from behind his beast's eyes. Without warning, she cuts skittishly across Avenue of the Stars, midway between two intersections, passing beside the little fountains in the avenue's median, outside the fanfare-slick grandeur of the CAA Building. Traipsing on across the bridge over West Olympic Boulevard and past the towering sleekness of Fox Plaza, she turns left into the more human scale of Galaxy Way. Halfway down the block, the marathon ends when she makes a right through the coiffed lushness of vegetation in the entrance drive of her residential complex. In this more intimate geography, peopled by sporadic pedestrians, the options available to Amber in his pursuit of her increase manyfold. 15 minutes later, Ashley emerges from a stairwell into the tightly coiffed communal garden space on the roof of her apartment building and perches on an upright garden seat. Sipping a cup of tea while her phone's mail app checks for new emails, she peers north through the haze of the afternoon to where the Hollywood Hills start to rise. 10 minutes later still, Amber emerges through the same stairwell, makes his way to a seat at the other end of the communal garden, sits and adjusts his shades against the glare. He looks sideways at Ashley. Perhaps she's busy this very minute, working on the IT infrastructure for Bangdad's Galscore Babe or Gross newsfeed. Perhaps she's proud of enabling the feed. Somehow, this matter-of-fact new view of her as being just a woman in her home environment reveals to Jaymi with greater clarity the dreary moral bankruptcy in her using her expertise to create something as ugly as Ain't They Freaky. Amber rises and steps along the roof garden path in her direction. When he reaches the path's closest point to her, she glances up and hears him speak Jamie's lines with a charismatic twinkling menace that's all his own. An oaf may end up more contented than a thinking and sensitive individual with high standards such as yourself, Ashley. But though the oaf may achieve 80% of his potential happiness, this will add up to 80% of very little. Whereas if you achieve just 40% of your potential happiness, then this will be 40% of very much more. You've known this all your life, Ashley, haven't you? The world's track record hardly inspiring confidence, however, you allowed yourself to become the problem. You feel the impatience of greatness in yourself, don't you? Reined and curbed by the dullness of the man you report to. Alas, this doesn't alter the fact that you remain the problem. Good day. He steps away from Ashley's spluttering remonstration and vanishes back down the stairwell. After 2 minutes of roiling and inconclusive thought, she gathers up her things, returns to her apartment downstairs, locks the door, and sits in front of the laptop computer on her desk, breathing hard. With the end of a fingernail, she smooths out a tiny dog ear at one corner of a small yellow sticky note that's been affixed with neat strips of sticky tape onto the flat plastic between the computer's keyboard and its fold-up screen, bearing her own handwritten words, Ashley Tweak most expertly sets up invisible girders. Her hand darts forward, hovers fretfully over the sticky note, as if about to rip it away, then hesitates and returns to her lap. Her gaze strays over to rest in reassuring habit upon a glazed and mounted black-and-white photograph positioned at one side of her desk, showing her as a child at her family's second home on Martha's Vineyard, where they would motor down from Cambridge for the summer break each year. Contemplating this, her face grows stricken with horror. Around the outside of the photo's metal frame, it would seem that a new outer frame has been stuck, made out of uncooked pale pink sausages that have been snugly squeezed into all the tight interstices and orifices of ornamental golden flossery on the metal. Her jaws commence a furious clenching when she observes, furthermore, that a fat horsefly has just landed on the uppermost sausage, where it is busy laying a line of tiny dark eggs. The clear glass that used to cover the picture has been shattered, while across the monochrome surface of the photo has been scrawled, "Grossest, 1,